there's two sentences in the national anthem, and it is, "We are children of a fighting race that have not yet known disgrace. But unfortunately, we do know disgrace now when they target the most vulnerable in society."
My name is Patrick Bond. I work up in American General Hospital. I'm in the support staff. And I hope that maybe with meetings like this here, that maybe the government will take stock. I mean, when are they going to practice what they preach? They still have their ministerial cares, they still have their expense account.
Rather than sitting at home, while the country goes from bad to worse, I've come here to see what the politicians have to say.
And the government, I mean, what they would spend on one meal for themselves is what I'm getting a week to care for my daughter.
No government, anyone in government shouldn't be in government that allows this to happen. Representatives that we're supposedly to have elected don't want to know. That's the long and short.
We would like to see the people of Ireland going on the streets like the people of France.
Again, and I've said this previously and I've said it during last week to the Taoiseach and to the Minister of Finance, that we should have had an election this year, that preferably we should have had an election in October, so that we can clear the air and so that our government of this country, government, as I said, our citizens of this country, can be put in place with an adequate 20 to 30 seat majority if necessary. And I say that because of the arithmetic in the Dáil, that will be free from the shackles of social partnership and free from the shackles of political Dutch auction.
This government, and indeed other political parties, have supported the privatisation of our health system. The reality is that if you are, the poorer that you are, the more marginalised communities that you come from, the least well off in terms of health you'll be. And that is not just me saying it. We have the Public Health Alliance in Ireland that points out that the death rates from cancer are 100% higher among the lowest paid and the most disadvantaged of our people.
We cannot actually get agreement on the principle that universally accessible, free at the point of use health provision would be a desirable thing. If we could get to the point where we could agree that that would be a desirable thing, then we can debate how to achieve it.
But you can't.
Why the people on the centre-right, who have parallels in Germany and Sweden and all these the developed countries, who are party to building, in one way or another, the high-standard, universally accessible and free health services, why they can't come on board and say, look, if we could do it, it would be a desirable thing.
Okay, I mean, say that if there's a will, there's a way. And 60 years ago, the late Dr. Noel Brown wiped out TB at the time monies were scarce. We can do the same if the world's there, but the world is not there. So I would hope changes will come about.
Okay,
more serious than that.
Yeah, well, that's what was going to be my next point. I mean, is there a sense that we're moving forward here at all?
Will you just wait and give
you
us
a chance? Wait, but everybody else is jumping in on this. I can't put up my hand.
I can hear your point of view, please.
Yes, I understand your anger, Donald Kay. Yes. And my sister's severely handicapped. She has had her sheets, nappies, catheters, wipes, you name it, she has had it taken off her. I mean, Dr. McDaid, you know her well. We're sick running to the GPs, ringing them, our time, our money, everything.
I am a staff nurse in the General Hospital. And whenever I saw defending our health services and workers in Donegal tonight, I came here as a healthcare worker who has a philosophy of care for caring for patients all over Donegal. I came here with the thoughts in my head, not of what the politicians could do for us in Dublin to change. I actually thought, what can the politicians do for us in Donegal to let Dublin let us keep our hospital that we have?
So it does need that big mass rally, that big mass kind of movement of people, not just in Donegal because we're too isolated, but it needs the Navans and the Monaghans and the Clares and people that value public services,
People that value health services, people that value frontline workers, standing together and looking a bit bigger than our county. Maybe
I have decisions to make as being on, as being the person who has a vote, shall we say, come the budget. So I do have decisions to make either the next few hours, the next few days, the next few weeks.
Government is a disgrace. Fianna Fáil are a disgrace. What they've done, they've let us down badly. I never, none of my family will ever vote for Fianna Fáil again. Never.